charge.
I need to talk to your daughter.
Over my dead body, Paco. All right? Relax. I'm real sorry, sir. You've come too far.
Andrew! Did you just lock us?
Listen to me. Okay, first off, I'm sorry about destroying your wedding cake. Going to second base with your mother, knocking your dad unconscious right there, and basically breaking up your wedding. Sorry. That being said, I am begging you, don't run away. All right? You and Paul have something so rare, all right, so powerful. Don't chicken out now.
Chicken out? He cheated.
Oh, get over it. It was years ago. All right, we're with some slutty friend of yours.
Yeah, that's true.
A friend, incidentally, who you're not even mad at. And you know why? Because you don't actually care. You love Paul so much you forgave him the second you heard. And that's what scares you.
You have no idea how I feel.
Yes,
no idea.
Yes, I do. I've been in your shoes. You know what? It scared the hell out of me, too. What if she hurt me? You know, what if she left me? What if she died? It would have been the end of me. So I cut it short before she ever could. And you know what? It was the biggest mistake I have ever made. And you're making that same mistake right now, and I'll be goddamned if I'm going to sit by and watch. You got to risk love, Sandra. Risk it. I didn't. Look at me. I'm an empty, lonely ghost of a man. It doesn't mean that you're never going to get hurt. But I can guarantee you this. Any pain that you feel will never, ever compare to the regret that comes from walking away from love. As someone who's felt a lot of both, trust me, pain beats regret every day of the week and twice on Sunday. Don't run away. Don't do it.
I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think you might be right.
So, you want to get married?